Hi, my name is Alex Thurston. In this video, I'll show you how to select a test time for your Alloy or Alloy Plus application using a Vanta analyzer. And also, I'll show you how to select SmartSort, which is a rapid sorting method for alloy analysis too. Test times using a Vanta analyzer are all about balance. You want a long enough test time that you have the accuracy and precision, but you also want a short test time so you can test a lot of samples at once. So in order to access the test time settings screen, at the bottom of your results screen, there's a clock icon. Clicking the clock icon brings you to the test time settings. So you can see a wide variety of information here. For beam one indicates the operation of the first beam that quantifies elements heavier than titanium. So on the periodic table, from titanium and up, that's what beam one accomplishes. Beam two, for an alloy application, provides information from elements starting with magnesium through sulfur. So, that said, what I need to do now is select test times for each beam. For beam one, a maximum test time of only 1 to 3 seconds is plenty of time to allow the analyzer to make a grade match decision. So for this application, I'm going to set a maximum test time in beam one of 2 seconds. So for beam two, setting a max test time here is a bit different. So these elements, again, magnesium through sulfur, are a little bit more difficult for the analyzer to resolve. So we need a little extra time than we do in beam one to resolve these elements. For general alloy sorting, I would recommend a test time in beam two of 7 seconds max, or if we're doing an aluminum with lower levels of magnesium, maybe 15 seconds is adequate to provide that information. So once we have our max test time set, we can also set a min test time, which forces the analyzer to operate for that set amount of time before displaying a result. Once my test time matrix is set, below I have the beam selection radio buttons that I can access here. Single beam with no LE is primarily used with our weld mask attachment, but if you know that your alloy does not have any LE information contained in it, it might be a valuable selection for you. For most alloys though, there's a little bit of silicon, a little bit of phosphorus, and so on and so forth. So if you're looking for a rapid test time utilizing beam one information only, single beam with LE is the likely choice there. If you're looking to have as much information as you can about your alloy test as you can possibly get out of the analyzer, two beams always is the way to go for you. And as the name implies, it uses two beams always. However, a rapid way of doing alloy sorting with as much information as we can provide the instrument is to use SmartSort. By using SmartSort, we allow the analyzer to make the choice of whether or not to use beam 2 in its analysis. So to demonstrate this, I have some alloy samples. By testing, I can see that in 2 seconds, I have an exact match for 4340 steel, and no beam 2 operation is needed. So a very quick way to provide an exact match for this alloy. Likewise, for another sample, you can see in my 2 second test, I have an exact match for Inconel 825. So again, SmartSort is a very rapid way to do alloy sorting effectively and accurately. So I hope that this video has helped you in your selection of test times for your Alloy or Alloy Plus method. Thank you for watching.